Hi guys, welcome to my VlossTube channel. My name is Ingeborg and the channel name is A Stitch Too Far. And welcome back if you're a long time viewer. Welcome as well if you're just stopping by and seeing what this is all about. I hope you enjoy the video. I'm gonna share with you what I've been stitching on for the past 2 weeks. Well, more like what I've not been stitching on. And just stock stitching. Hope you are all well. This is the weekend of the floss tube retreat in Austin, and I've seen a bit of footage from that, which looks amazing. Looks like you're all having fun. It's a bit surreal to see everybody I know, sorry about the air quotes, but in the same room stitching along. It's lovely, and I must confess I'm a bit jealous, but yeah, we'll get over it. Let's see. Before I forget, I wanted to mention a new Flosstuber. I think she's already been mentioned by other people, but this is a person that I was following on Instagram for quite a while and loving what she was working on. She has, she's pretty adventurous in her stitching. She does try out lots of different techniques, and her Instagram name is the same as her Flosstube channel. I think it's Handmade. I will put her in the description. Go check her out. Her first video is wonderful. She just shares her stitching story, how she started, how she progressed, what choices she made for projects. And it was wonderful to listen to and see her beautiful work. So go check her out. Give her some Flosstube love. Anything else? No, then I can move on to stitching, because last week, so not this week, which ended this Sunday, but the week before, I was struck ill. Basically, after my Flosstube video went live or uploaded, that night I was just awful, and I had been not feeling well all weekend already, but yeah. So I had the flu, basically, and that was annoying because I had work stuff to do. So I did work and sort of get home as quick as I can and go into bed and do the same thing the next day. But yeah, in the end, I survived and everything is well. But yeah, it wasn't fun, and I definitely did not stitch at all last week. And I picked it up again Monday, I think, this Monday. So I'm only stitching on two pieces, because I did stitch a bit on Sunday and today on the Tree of Stitches, which is a, I'm not going to show you the pattern because it is just that, but it's by Bee's Needlework. If you Google that, I will also try and look it up. But she does amazing, beautiful specialty stitches work. And I was working on the Tree of Stitches, and I've gotten to the 6th stitch that I'm working on currently. So the trunk, the tree trunk, is just cross stitch, and the rest is different types of specialty stitches. So we have Smyrna crosses and lots and lots and lots of French knots, and then eyelets, and then rice stitch, and the one I'm working on now is, I think it's the cushion stitch, not sure. Excuse me. But yeah, I'm loving it. This is with Dinky Dye silk for the green. It's called Bunya Grass. Loving it and having a lot of fun with this. And the other piece I worked on, I finished. It's the Bud Snakes, as we've come to know it, better known as Mother Maya. by Ink Circles. And I used 32 count Lugana by PixoDis Plus for the fabric. It's the colorway Legacy. And I did use the recommended or suggested threads for this piece, which are by Caris Creation. I'll try and link her below. And it's called Mojave Fire. Yeah, Mojave Fire. And I think she suggests something like, I'm not sure if she had suggested how, oh yeah, 8 skeins were used in the model. So somehow I got 11 skeins. I don't know why, but I did. And I guess I wanted to be sure and be safe, but this is what I've got left. So I've got little less than half left. I used 6 skeins for this, and I did do have a little bit left, but I'm very frugal in stitching, and also I used 32 count and the model might have been stitched on 28 count. But yeah, my stitches are very tight and I'm very frugal, so that's probably why I only had to use 6 skeins. But yeah, that means I still have plenty left to maybe do another piece with the same colorway. So, no loss there. But of course you want to see what my finish looks like. I think you want to see. And here it is. I've had it rolled up. Yeah, this is the whole piece. It's pretty close to the right color. Trying to see what this. Yeah, you can get a close up of. I don't know what you're seeing now, so I'm just sort of moving it along, but yeah. I had so much fun. The last bit, this border was getting a bit tedious by the end, but it was so much fun because every motif is just funny and interesting to stitch and just long enough that you don't get bored with it, except maybe just the bottom one. But oh yeah, I love it. So this one will have to get framed. So I'm gonna have to go look for a frame. And that's all I worked on. So let's just move into the next thing I wanted to talk about, because I went rummaging through my stuff, my stash, and I noticed that I have accumulated quite a few finishes that I'm not yet fully finished. So it's gonna have to be a goal to get some ideas for that and sort out some time to get those done. But yeah, after I finished that, I had a big itch to start something new. And I wasn't sure what to do because Christmas is coming. And I do want to start some Christmas things and pick up my Christmas piece that I was working on last year. We don't have Halloween or Thanksgiving, obviously. So that's the two things that are coming up are Sinterklaas, Santa Claus's birthday on December 5th, which is a children's holiday, I guess. And Christmas. So those are both in December, and I was thinking I might pick up, because I have my scroll bars free now for something, and I didn't want to put on a new start because I want to put on the Christmas piece. Rambling. But yeah, so I did put it on my scroll bar, so I'll just show you what it looks like so you remember maybe. because I didn't work on it, but yeah, when I took it out, I was really excited to start working on that again. So this is by the owner of my LNS. Yeah, that's okay. Can't quite see the whole thing, but it's going to be a full round pattern. It's called Christmas Globe, I guess you could say. And I don't have a picture of the pattern, but I will try and look for one and put it in. But yeah, this is one I want to get to work on again. And I was figuring, it seems like everybody's thinking about their rotation and what they want to work on lately. And I've had the same thing. I have enjoyed very much working on the same piece for a week and having a focus piece, but I do still feel the itch to start things. So I have been thinking, maybe I pick out one or two big pieces that will be my focus and maybe pick out a few small ones that I could work on towards Christmas, just as a sort of to break up the monotony of stitching on one piece. So I'm thinking that I will take out this one as well as save the stitches and work on those until the end of the year, and mix it up with some small ones that I'm going to show you that I've basically kitted up. Yeah. And that way, if I get burnt out on Christmas things by December, then that's no problem. Because then I have lots and lots and lots of other things that I can start working on anyway. But maybe if I do it like this, I will get some extra finishes for Christmas decoration, which is always nice. Yeah. So that's that. And I did notice I forgot to take something out that I want to show you later, but that will get there in a minute. So I've been kitting up things. And they're all Christmas related except for one, which I'll keep till the end. So I still have these two. I might start these when I need a train project, just for the stitching bit, not for the bead bit, but they're pretty easy to see and small, easy to put in my bag if I don't forget to put it in. Yeah, there's gonna be lots of crinkling, people. So this one I think I bought at the start of this year. What's it called? 1831 Christmas. I love it because I was in my sheep phase, but I still love it. And I've been looking for what I wanted to stitch it on. I was thinking I might want to stitch it on a 28 or 31 count over one, but I didn't like any of the fabric options that I had, and I didn't really want to order another fabric just for that because it's just a really small piece. So I'm going to go for my trusty 40 counts, and I picked out all the gentle arts that I need because I already had them. Okay. Lots of the variations of white and reds and a few greens, and I'm going to stitch it on a really wrinkly, really showing up to light, but this is the Vintage Country Mocha 40 counts by Swigart. And I think it'll work perfectly on that. I did consider maybe a gray one, gray fabric, but I tried it with the flosses and for me it didn't really work out too well with that. So we'll see how this pans out, but that is one of the smalls. Then I got two in my so-and-so that I think I showed you already. This is the Just Nan one. It's snowing men. And it has embellishments. This is just another small one, and I am going to do that on a 32 count because that's recommended and I have the embellishments. So I'm just going to do this 2/2 with DMCs on 32 counts. And this is a linen called Flex by Swigart. It's showing up lighter than it is, but not that much lighter. Yeah, it is recommended and I had it in my stash. Then we have the Sue Hillis one, Shiver Me Timbers. And I'm sorry you can't see it fully, but I showed you last time, so you can see it here. And I'm stitching this on a... I have to check. It is a vintage gray, but I'm not sure what count. Oh, it's a 32 count. Yeah, pretty much like that. Belfast, vintage gray, Swigart. And it calls for DMC, so I should be able to get that started without any problems. And those were the ones I am planning to start. So I will definitely start one or more of these. And maybe start either one of these when I have a lot of train traveling to June. Excuse me. And then there's one more that I'm going to start, I think, today. Because of I was rummaging through my stash and I found this. This is a freebie by Modern Folk Embroidery on Etsy. He is a Dutch guy, Jacob something, but he lives in England. I'll link his shop because he's on my number one of getting some patterns from him. He's got Modern Folk Embroidery and he's got something with dark stitches. I think McKenna may have had his Pepe pattern. I'm not sure. I will link both below. But I thought for me this was very appropriate for how I was feeling this week with everything that has been happening in the world. It's better to light a single candle than to curse the darkness. Meaning for me it's better to take action than just blame the wrong thing. And I'm not going to say anything else before someone tells me that I'm not supposed to meddle in another country's politics. But yeah, I have two options for this. I have a dark gray 32 counts. Oh yeah, like that. And I have a white off-white bamboo. And the other option is a really, really, really dark brown. It's like, what's that, 3371 or something like that, DMC. It looks black. It's called Onyx, by the way, by Weeks Dye Works. It's Weeks Dye Works, so I'm not a fan, but I thought it might look really nice with the blue. So I'm not sure. I think I might try this and see how I like it and maybe switch to the gray if I don't like it. But I was thinking over one, I think, 32/1. Yeah, because then I can make it into a really nice tiny pillow and stuff it in my other things. So yeah, this will get started today, I think, just because I feel like it. And then let's see. Yeah, I'm going to have to plan. I've been trying to get to my LNS for the past few weekends, but then I got sick, and then yesterday I was too busy. So hopefully next weekend I need to check if she's open, because I think there might be a trade show somewhere. But yeah, because I want to check if her Christmas pattern is out yet. I think it should be coming out around this time, and I want to pick that up. And I need some threads. I want some threads, because I watched Darling Bluebell's video yesterday, and I saw the new floss that she showed us at the visit the other time. The LNS owner showed it as her that she was going to come out with that, and that is some gorgeous thread, I can tell you that. So I need to check that out, and I wanted to ask her about the stitch that she mentioned for the rim of the hardanger piece that I'm doing, because I want to make sure that I understand her correctly and try a bit of stitching on that before I finish that and get it out of my whip pile. But yeah, so hopefully next weekend. If anybody ever plans to go to the LNS, let me know, because I might try and swing by if you're in town. But yeah. And then I have to pause because I have something that I want to share with you. Hang on just a sec. Yeah, because I got happy mail from Sylvia in Germany, with a beautiful picture of her beached on the Ostsee, or I guess it's Eastern Lake, because Zee is lake and Zee is sea in Dutch, but Zee is lake in German. So that's always confusing to me, but yeah, lovely. It's going up on my board, and she added this beautiful handmade pillow, which I absolutely love, with a little rose pendant on it, and it's filled with lavender, and oh, it smells so wonderful that I hang it up on my magnifier. That's why I forgot to bring it, my stitching magnifier, and every time I pull that down or pull it up, it gives off a little bit of lavender scent, which is lovely. So thank you very much, Sylvia. And she added this too, and I have not yet unpacked it because it looks so beautiful in her wrapping. And I have a sneaking suspicion that you made this one too, because it's signed. And I just absolutely love this, and I think it will be on my Christmas tree at least. And then I'm going to have to look for a place to put it, but yeah, I love it. Thank you very much, Sylvia. That was really, really, really nice of you. Oh, and she got me some lovely chocolates. So yeah, that was awesome. Thank you so much, Sylvia. I really appreciate it. Anything else I need to talk about? Yeah. I'm sorry for those who watched my previous update and then couldn't comment, or had their comment deleted, because I had to remove that upload and redo the upload, because I had added on the beginning and on the end of the video a small audio clip of that song, the Mersey Goat song, Mersey Doat song, because I just thought it was funny. And then when I had it uploaded, I got a notification that there was a copyright on it, and I didn't get like a warning or something, but just that there was a German company that has a copyright of it, and I didn't really have to do anything about it, but I just got sort of freaked out. And they had options to try and get the sound muted on it, and I tried that first and it didn't work, so in the end I really had to go back to my own laptop and take out the audio and re-upload. And by that time, and I think almost 100 people had already viewed it. But yeah, so that one I had to remove, and I'm sorry. I lost the comments when I removed the video, so I might have to go to my mail account and see if they are in there so that I can reply to you in the next video or something if you have a question. But yeah, I'm sorry, that was a bit silly of me that I didn't think there would be, because it's a song from 1944. I really didn't think there would be copyright on it. But I didn't check. So yeah, lesson learned. So apologies if you got stuck trying to comment on that. But yeah, so that brings me to something else, because YouTube has been changing its editor possibilities, and I've heard that you now just can't edit in YouTube anymore. I use Windows Movie Maker, but I also discovered when I was making the videos on the flip-throughs that Windows Movie Maker isn't supported any longer, or isn't available for download anymore, because I wanted to put it on another computer and I couldn't download it. So I was looking for another editing program, and I have downloaded and tried to use, what's it called? The one that Blitzstitch uses. And I have a question about that. So if you're a FlossTube video maker, here's my question. If you use the, I will put the name of the program somewhere here, because I just can't remember. It's something like Shotgun or something, but not that. Something with shot in it, anyway. If you use that, how do you insert a title page and a finish page? Because in Movie Maker, I can make a title page in Movie Maker and add it in. And I found that in that shot program, I can't do that. I have to get a theme somewhere and put it in outside of the program. So I have to download it from somewhere. And I've been trying to find free examples of that, like themes or title pages, or, and if you Google for it, you get a lot of hits, but they all lead to pages that in the end are not free or not copyright free. So please let me know, if you use that program, how do you make your title page? Do you make it in a different program and add it in, or do you get it from somewhere where I can get copyright free downloads? Let me know, please, because I want to switch to that program, but I couldn't, because I couldn't put in the title, and I didn't feel right to not put in the title when I've always done that in the past video. So yeah, need to know. Excuse me. So that is all I have to share with you at this time, I think. I know the other retreat, the other FlossTube retreat is coming up soon as well. So I am going to say, I am going to wish you a lot of fun if you're going to that. And Orietta, I agree, we have to come up with our own version, like a European FlossTube retreat. So if you have, anyone who's watching, if you have any suggestions for how we could do that, let me know, because I'm sure we can figure something out, and maybe, I don't know, rotate to a different country each year or something. But I just want to have fun like the people in America are having fun. Anyway, that's it for me. I hope you are going to have a wonderful 2 weeks of stitching and anything else that you're planning to do. I hope you're all healthy and well, and yeah, see you in 2 weeks. Bye, guys.